Let me ask you this, because we're kind of touching on the subject of reincarnation and different lives and things like that. And I understand what you're saying, that we can come into this life, which could be a very short life, could be a very long life, or we could just go, this is the only thing I'm really, my main goal of my soul blueprint is to be, you know, deal with being an alcoholic and how and overcome that, or being a singer and dealing with fame, or being a mother and being a parent, or whatever those things are. And it doesn't have to be grandiose. It could be small and simple for that soul's evolution.
Right.
But you know that on the show, I've had so many different near-death experiencers on the show. Mm-hmm. What is Bashar's take on near-death experiences, and what these souls are kind of, and why do they even go through those experiences?
Yeah, well, a lot of them, those are the moments that they've chosen to sort of open their eyes and awake to their purpose in life, because a lot of near-death people, when they do return, are very changed. They understand now, they sort of have a goal of service. They see things very differently. They understand physical reality to be a projection of our consciousness. They're more prone to being helpful to other people, kind to other people, compassionate about people that are not like them, because they understand they're on a different journey. So near-death experience is almost like having a reset button. And many people have chosen to have that reset button at certain points in their life. And at the same time, it provides us with more information about the next phase of our lives, because death is not the end, it's just a transition. Mm-hmm. And in fact, it's just a transition back to our natural state. So this is the unnatural state. This is the temporary experience. Many people associate the near-death experience with having gone home for a brief period of time. Mm-hmm. And therefore, that really is a glimpse into what awaits all of us when we wake up from this self-imposed physical dream, so to speak.
I've heard this said many times, that us, we're all obviously souls. Mm-hmm. That's not a question. That we're expressions of God, mm-hmm. Or source energy, or however, whatever the word you want to use. And that energy, that source, is experiencing everything through us, through the trees, through the bugs, through the earth, through planets, through solar systems,
there's
everything.
Nothing that is not it.
Correct. The big question is, why does it need to do that?
It's not a matter of need. See, that's a very human question, because
right.
we're experiencing things like beginnings and endings and wants and desires. It's just its nature. That's just what it is. It's like, you know, trying to explain something that is just innate. It's the nature of existence to experience itself, because I don't want this to get too complicated. Everything is one thing from different perspectives.
Mm-hmm.
But the only way to have different perspectives, to know itself in all the ways that it can, is to sort of create this illusion of separation, this illusion of other than itself. Because you can't really have self-awareness if there isn't an other than self to measure against. You only know yourself if there's something that is apparently not you, so that you can distinguish between the two. So just the very nature of the polarity of the one that is unbroken, and yet a part of it knows itself as distinct from the one. And that's what Bashar refers to as all that is, the part that knows itself as everything. That starts the whole ball rolling right there. Just that ability to see the reflection of the self, to know the self-awareness automatically starts the concept of experiencing yourself in all the ways that it's possible to experience yourself. And on that level, on that highest level, since it is everything, it's going to simply experience itself as everything that it is. That's just the natural result of self-awareness, of consciousness. It's the natural quality of consciousness.
So as we are experiencing and evolving as souls, as expressions of source energy, of God, We obviously keep elevating and elevating and growing in levels, like us and our ascended masters that we know, like a Jesus, a Buddha, you know, right. These kind of people. At a certain point, though, we will get to the top of this mountain and go back into God.
There's no end to it. Because think about it this way. Let's say you reach what, from your perspective, is the top. Well, there's a collection, an infinite collection of tops. Right? It never ends because it never began. So you can always find a new perspective. You can always create a new experience. Amen. So even if you seem to reach the ultimate, then you have to realize, but there's an infinity of ultimates of different kinds, different perspectives of ultimates. So it never ends.
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.